Nevada is without a doubt the most beautiful state in the country. And it comes with a very rich history too. A history that includes the Marlette Water System, an engineering feat unlike any other in our country's history. And it has left clues, clues of a time gone by. Let's go exploring. My guide today is Jay Howard, the supervisor for the Lake Tahoe Nevada State Park.
Hi there, John. Good to meet you.
Good seeing you. How's everything?
Everything's good.
So, what I really want to know about is the water system. When did it get started? By who?
Well, the Marlette Lake Water System is how we know it today. When it was originally developed and created, it was known as the Virginia Gold Hill Water System. And that company, the Virginia Gold Hill Water Company, was put together in order to supply that resource to the Comstock. They needed water for all of the steam engines, for the milling of all the valuable ore, and for the people to survive in a desert community over there in Virginia City.
How did they pump that water all the way over the mountain into Virginia City?
They built the diversion dam. They built 14 miles of box looms one season. Then the next year, 1873, they built the first siphon pipe that carried water through Washoe Valley here. So they collected the water at Hobart Creek and carried it over to Virginia City in 1873. That was the first part of the water system.
Jay, whose house is this?
This is J.B. Overton's house. This house was built expressly for him. He was the first superintendent for the water system, and he oversaw all of the expansions over the years.
The original water system reached 21 miles in length and could deliver over 2 million gallons per day from Hobart Creek to Virginia City. The Comstock's increasing water demand resulted in the addition of a second flume system in 1875, doubling its capacity.
This is Marlette Lake. It was a body of water that was developed for the water company's second expansion when there was another bonanza, another gold strike, gold and silver strike down in Virginia City. Each time that happened, they needed more and more water. This water was initially used for logging purposes to feed the V flumes that carried lumber. So when the water company got back this far, they got permission from the logging company that owned the lake to take as much water as they needed. So they built the dam higher, and they built the flume system that carried water from this lake over to the tunnel into the rest of the water system.
So the dam was originally put in when?
The dam was originally put in the early 1860s.
And then it was expanded or raised about when?
In 1875.
Since Hobart Creek was not providing enough water to the mines, the Virginia and Gold Hill Water Company turned to the Marlette Lake as an alternative, raising the dam to expand the lake.
So Jay, this is the Red House?
This is the Red House flume tender station. This is where the flume tender lived and his family. And then over here is the bunkhouse that housed the summer crews that came up to maintain the box flume.
A box flume is a man-made structure built along the natural terrain that uses gravity to transport water for human consumption and mechanical use. It was the job of a flume tender to keep the flumes repaired and the water flowing. The Marlette Water System had six flume stations.
This is a restoration project that we've started on. Right now, we're just stabilizing the structure. We have recently had it lifted up and a concrete foundation poured underneath, and just the other day it was lifted back down.
In 1911, the Hobart Dam broke and washed away the original Red House built in 1875.
But there's wires coming out, so you didn't have electricity out here back then, did they?
There was no electricity, but all these flume tender stations were tied together with a phone system after the turn of the century, so that even down in Virginia City, they could call up here and see what's going on with the water system.
The Red House was recently listed on the National Register of Historic Places.
Jay, is this part of the system as well?
This is, yeah. This is part of the water system that continues to function today. This is the 18-inch transmission line, the main pipe that all the water goes into from these different collection points up above us. Everything into this pipe, and then on out to the number two pipe, the inverted siphon, that carries water through Washoe Valley and continues to function today.
The system as a whole transported water by gravity through a combination of flumes and a tunnel. The inverted siphons pushed the water through the Washoe Valley and up to the Virginia Range.
This is the inlet to the siphon pipes that carried all the water that they collected up in the backcountry, brought it via box flume to this point, the water went into these siphon pipes and basically went down the slope through the Washoe Depression or Washoe Valley down there, and then back up the Virginia Range on the other side and over to the Comstock, Virginia City.
How much water were they pumping in over there?
With the first siphon pipe, it was 2 million gallons a day. After the system was completed, it was 10 million gallons a day.
That is a game changer if you lived
gallons.
In Virginia
yeah,
City.
That's a lot of water. That is a lot of water.
I'm in awe.
Yeah, well, this was the part of the project that was most amazing to me anyways. And when you read about it and things like that, it's just described as a feat of engineering that had really never been done before.
The new additions to the Marlette Water System fueled the Comstock up in the hills of Virginia City. Companies worked together for one common goal, gold.
Oh, Jay, this is it, huh?
Yeah, this is the tunnel.
Wow. So tell me about this. This goes all the way through?
This was a 3,994-foot tunnel, almost a mile long, that they built in order to get Marlette water from inside the basin to the outside of the basin.
Huge amount of history standing here before us.
This park has this historic water system within its boundaries. So we sort of feel like we're the stewards of this historic water system because, you know, there's nobody else to take care of it but us.
And you know, if you didn't know any better, you'd just be looking at some lumber that's rotting and a keep out sign.
Yeah, this is a well-kept secret. We want to try to fix that so that more people can see what we have back here.
Yeah.
After the decline of mining, the water system was sold to a couple of different companies. It was not until 1963 that the state of Nevada purchased what was left of it, diverting part of the water to Carson City.
One big happy circle we just made, Jay. We're back at JB's house, and I'm thinking, that really was a marvel what they pulled off, wasn't it?
It really was, yes, yes, sir.
What were some of the stats?
We're talking about 46 miles of box flume, 21 miles of inverted siphon pipe, because there were three of those, 7 miles each, six maintenance stations, four reservoirs, and a whole lot of work to keep that water flowing.
Yeah, all that stuff, and it really boiled down to the human spirit making it happen. Jay, thanks so much. I had a blast today, I really did.
Yeah, today was great. Let's do it again sometime.
You're on, man.